Very often, when people create forms in Word, they put multiple underscores together to create a line for a field. This is super unprofessional, since these lines will all end at slightly different locations. Instead of underscores, we should make use of tables to create a form with a uniform design. For that, we go to the Insert tab, click on Table, and in the Selection pane, we select a 3x2 table. After the table is inserted, we click into it and go to the Layout tab within the Table Tools. Here, we click on Cell Margins and set all margins to 0. This will allow us to insert text which starts right next of the table border. Then, we select the whole table and switch to the Design tab, again within the Table Tools. Where it says Borders, we click on the little arrow to open more options, and here we select No Border. Afterwards, we select the first column, open the border options again, and select Bottom Border. And let's open these options again, and additionally select Inside Horizontal Border. Now we repeat this step also for the last column. The Center Table column will be our spacer, and therefore it won't have any border color. Let's now resize the table. We can drag the borders of this second column to the center of the page to make the column gap smaller, but I'd actually recommend to set an exact width for each column. So let's say that our page is 21 centimeters wide and we have 2.5 centimeter page margins. This leaves us with 16 centimeters of space for the full table width. If we want the center gap to be 0.5 centimeters, then the first and last column of the table should be 7.75 centimeters. So we click into the first column, switch to the Layout tab again, and enter 7.75 centimeters for the width. Then we do the same for the last column, and for the center column, we enter 0.5 centimeters. And with that, we now have a perfectly symmetrical two-column form layout with a small gap in the center. The only thing left to do is to populate the table. And of course, if we need to add more rows, we can simply extend the table by going to the Layout tab within the Table Tools again and clicking on Insert Below. By the way, the dotted lines that we are seeing around the table are only grid lines to help us with the layouting of the table. These dotted lines won't be printed, of course. If that video was the solution to your problem, then please support the channel by hitting the like and the subscribe button. Thanks a lot, and I see you in the next one.